Welcome to MotoBrief TV, episode 8. Today we're bringing the final footage from our trip to the Seattle International Motorcycle Show. First, I want to talk about the MCN Fantasy Road Race 2008. Now, this year, Motorcycle News is making the Fantasy Road Race free. So I've set up my team, a private league for MotoBrief, and I'm going to give away some great prizes, including an Arai helmet to the top finishers in the MotoBrief league. Just head over to the Fantasy Road Race page and sign up. You'll need to join League 38 to compete for MotoBrief prizes. Please keep in mind that we don't have any relationship with MCN except as fans, so after joining our league, you'll need to send me an email to let me know who your team is. You'll find more details in the show notes at MotoBrief.tv. Now let's see some more of the Seattle show.
Is it discontinued?
It's being replaced.
Replaced with what?
Replaced
with 690. Wait, come tell me. What are we going to replace it with? Come on.
It's going to get...
Pimp the new bike, man. I'm a whore for dual sports.
This bike is being replaced by a 690 Adventure, which should know the more approximate date of when it's been replaced, about March or April.
Okay.
So.
All right.
Newer motor.
Smoother motor. You know, just more modern updates.
That new motor, is that the one that's made some appearances in some races and stuff?
Yeah, it's the same motor that's being ran in the 690 Supermoto and the 690 Duke. Twin balance shaft, you know, running a lot smoother at the higher RPMs that these bikes are capable of. Smoother motor, more comfortable.
Excellent. Thanks a lot, man. Appreciate it. I really need this motorcycle.
Okay, hello again. We're here with Michael from the Washington Motorcycle Safety Program. Can you tell us a little bit about your program?
I sure can. The Washington Motorcycle Safety Program is a program within the Department of Licensing for Washington. We are 100% funded by endorsement fees, so it's not tax dollars. It's riders paying for other riders to be safer on the road so that we all get home safely together. And we have, I think, 15 training sites all around the state that do beginner and experienced motorcycle training. And when you complete our training, if it's a state contracted provider, then you get a completion card that waives any further testing from the Department of Licensing. So it's a very convenient way and a low investment way to not only learn some good skills, but also to get your endorsement without having to take your bike to the Department of Licensing to test.
How can I take this class? What should I do? Website?
Probably the quickest way is to go to our website, which is www.endorseyoursport.com, and that will provide various links to not only testing sites, but all of our state training providers. And that's probably the quickest way. Just click on take a class, and that will take you to our statewide training list. Call the training provider most local to you, and they will also have websites which might include their scheduling.
Is that a 3-day class?
In some cases, it can be a 2-day class. It's between 15 and 20 hours for the beginner class and approximately 5 to 6 hours for the experience course. But it does get extremely popular starting around March, and that's when you'll have 2 or 3 month waits. So if you want to take it in March or April, call in January.
Thank you so much. Okay, so as many of you know, I'm in the market for my first bike, and I want to know what you guys think. What should I get? Leave your comments on the blog or email me at rachel@motorbrief.tv and let me know what you think. It's cool. It's black.
I got speak and you want to listen up.
I'm with Luca from Best Rest Products. We're going to talk about the cycle pump, one I think their most popular gadgets. So, all right.
The system starts with the Easy Air gauge. It's a crucial part of the equation. What's great about the Easy Air gauge is that it's got a locking chuck. So you can attach it to the airline and it'll stay fixed, and then you've got a constant pressure reading. Unlike a lot of other air gauges, which are a dead end, we've put an air inlet on this side. So you know that right now you've got 30 pounds of pressure, which is not quite enough for a front tire. So using the locking chuck then off of the cycle pump, go on, attach, and then turn the cycle pump on, which has been plugged into your power adapter on your bike. and you can watch the airflow. So rather than with a conventional gauge where you're checking the air and then putting air and then checking the air and going back and forth, this is a one-shot deal. Now you'd asked, why not just get a Walmart pump, tear it apart, and build it myself? You could do this. We've already done it for you. We've taken a much higher quality air compressor mechanism, put it in this very, very sturdy aluminum casing, and added the adventure legs, which keep it up off the ground so it doesn't get dirt inside the casing. We've got the full variety of plugs, so it's all there in a complete kit, built up, ready to go. And it's extremely rugged. We've sold 10,000 of them. We've had one come back for a failure. That's it. So
that's excellent. So does it fold down?
Yes, it does. The legs fold down like that. Then all the cords wrap up. So you can take the Easy Air gauge, put it inside the cycle pump bag, along with a pocket plugger kit, and you've got everything that you need to get yourself going and stay going on the road. Tire maintenance and repair. And it all runs in at about $150.
That's great, man. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it.
I want to thank everyone for watching. We've had lots of new people showing up at the website from all over the world. If you're new to the show, you can catch old episodes at MotoBrief.tv, and you can subscribe via RSS. You can look us up on iTunes. You can watch us using the Miro player. You can also subscribe by email, and you'll get contacted every time a new episode is posted. Links to subscribe are on the site. And until next time, ride often and ride safe.